the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design, in the lives of those who prove His faithfulness, who walk by faith and not by sight.
If you've never been on a short-term missions trip, you need to go on a short-term missions trip sometime in your life.
With the power of His promise in their hearts, of a holy city built by God's own hand, a place where peace and justice reign.
God's put on your heart to go on a short-term mission trip, answer that and follow. Amen.
By faith the prophet saw a day when the longed-for Messiah would appear, with the power to break the chains of sin and death, and rise triumphant from the grave. By faith the church was called to go in the power of the Spirit to the lost, to deliver captives and to preach good news in every corner of the earth.
Go over there and be a part of that is a humbling experience, because it's such a privilege, because it's God's work and we get to be a part of God's work for that small amount of time.
Great, great experience. When we were there, we were challenged. Ted, who is the foreman, Ted Weinberg, Ted and Diane, who we lived with for the 2 weeks, he gave us, right away, he gave us a challenge, and three goals for us as a team and even for him. Now, this guy's a builder. I mean, that's what he's there to do. He's to build stuff, to get stuff done. So when he said the number one priority is, like, if anything else, this is number one priority, that we would make God look good. That was the number one thing that he said, that we would make God look good. Secondly, that we would be changed. And thirdly, that we would get something done. And, you know, for us sitting there, like, well, wait a minute, we're here to build stuff, right? We're here to get stuff done. And it was just great to hear that. It was a great challenge. It was a great to put everything in perspective and to get our priorities right. Even though we were there to build, the number one thing was to make God look good in everything that we were doing.
It was very open, honest, transparent, a lot of laughter, a lot of tears. It was truly a great time for us to build, to fellowship together, to build the bond of love, brothers in Christ. And, you know, we're all sinners. We all have struggles. And hearing everybody present their story and see how God worked in their life to accomplish or to work through that roadblock, or, you know, you can imagine there's 10 of us in this group, and unfortunately Josh is not with us, but we all have struggles day to day, fighting this world and the temptations and living for ourselves. And it was very rewarding to hear everybody open up, be honest, share. You know, it's a challenge to come back here after what we experienced over there, to get your arms around and your hearts and your minds of what we experienced and what we have here. We have so much stuff. And we take so much for granted. And, you know, it's been a challenge coming back here and getting back into this life, but more importantly, wanting to be changed.
So a lot of us, we didn't even know each other. And, you know, like Jim Hall and I, you know, I just knew he played the drums. Other than that, you know, we'd pass and just kind of, and we worked together about the whole time. And we really got to be good friends and grew and got to know each other. And that's an amazing thing. And just to be there, to be able to serve, just like all these guys have said, it's to be there with the Weinbergs.
You know, to share your testimony is a good thing, you know, and that you should do that, because you have a testimony that can help others, you know. And I just give so much thanks to these guys, but just even more thanks that God put these guys into my life and that he's helped me learn from them.
We had an opportunity to meet last night and share, six of us that made it over to Ken's last night around the circle of fire instead of the circle and trust in Togo. But, you know, I love these guys, and we're here to support each other, to pray for one another, encourage, and hold each other accountable for that. And if God's put on your heart to go on a short-term mission trip, answer that and follow.
Amen.
We worked in a big maintenance building, which is probably the major building on the site at this time before the hospital. And the first time we walked in the building, and it's maybe nearly the size of this auditorium, it might be a little bit wider actually, it was just a mess of things from this project. And yet we just started, and Ted has a plan. Ted always has a plan, and so we just started in there. Most of us in that building, Abe and Craig, two guys that like to paint, did a great job painting in the guest house. Well, at least they volunteered. I don't know if they liked it or not, but at least they volunteered. And nobody else's hands went up, but they volunteered to do that. And then Big Canna and Matt were working on the guest house also, and the duplex, putting up an awning, keep the sun off the windows, which was a very important job too. And then the rest of us guys all worked in this maintenance building. And by the time we got done, that maintenance building was transformed on the inside, organized, and Ted was so pleased. He was just about nearly in tears, you know, with the work that we had got done. And when I say with the work that we had got done, not one of these guys here would boast in themselves. We are all so blessed to be a part of that project. It's hard, like Craig says, to capsulize this in 2 minutes, what we did in 2 weeks. Yeah. But to go over there and be a part of that is a humbling experience, because it's such a privilege, because it's God's work. And we get to be a part of God's work for that small amount of time.
Psalm 139 really became important to me the first time I went, right beforehand. From my point of view, I stumbled upon it. From God's point of view, he led me to it. And you got to go home and read Psalm 139, I'm telling you. But I think there's nothing more important in the believer's life than have an accurate picture of God. And if you have an accurate picture of God, you've got a big picture of God. And that's what Psalm 139 does for you. Why Psalm 139 is so effective at that time is simply because you're away from everything. I mean, you know you're in Africa when you see a bug going across the floor, and instead of stepping on it, you watch it because it's entertainment as it runs around the room, you know? And you're actually excited when it passes the two ahead of them because they stop to drink a little drop of coffee on the floor, you know? And because you've got nothing when you're there. You've got each other, you've got your work, you've got your relationship to God, but all these things we think are so important, you know, the American Pickers, you know, on Monday night, and all these things that we got, we can't miss, you know? You don't have that. And so it's all stripped away, so you have time to think about your relationship to God and how important he is in your life. And Psalm 139 just shows, you know, how intricately God is involved in our lives. And just the one thought in particular that I shared a little bit that first day we're back, and just the fact that, you know, in verse 5 it says that God goes before us, he follows behind us, and he places his hand of blessing in our heads. You know, and if God's got us all, if he's all around us and he's got his hand, what can happen to us? Mm-hmm. If you honestly know that God is involved in your life and that he's planning your life and he has thoughts about you and he loves you, then all those things we face in life, no matter how difficult, man, it's different than those who have no hope. Because we know that God is there with us. He goes before us. He goes behind us. He puts his hand of blessing on our heads.
Amen. You know, it was a trip of a lifetime. It's hard to put 16 days into a couple minutes, yeah. But it truly was a life-changing experience.
Wow. But it was great. I mean, I definitely go again. I was definitely really nervous about going this time before we went, just because, you know, job and everything else and leaving your family. But I would do it again in a heartbeat.
Yeah. But it was a spiritual blessing, and yet the devil works on you there too. And it's not just easy to go there and stuff, and it was trying for me spiritually, and yet the Lord blessed me, and I don't know if I could do it again or not, but I would encourage anybody that feels like they need to go, you need to go, because the Lord will bless you and use you like you can't understand until something you do something like that.
Wow. If you've never been on a short-term missions trip, you need to go on a short-term missions trip sometime in your life, and maybe, as has been privileged by a number of these guys, several times in your life. Because it'll change your life. It really will change your life. And anybody who's been on a short-term missions trip can verify that.
In the morning, when I arise, in the morning, when I rise, in the morning, when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, you can have all this world, just give me Jesus.